Julia Garner snagged the role of the Silver Surfer in the Fantastic Four reboot. But here's the twist. This reboot might be in a whole different universe. Rumor has it that Marvel might be cooking up another Silver Surfer with a different actor. Crazy, right? Also, stick around till the end as we discuss how the Silver Surfer can be a woman. But before we get into that, let's chat about who could rock the role of a solo Silver Surfer in a movie.
Not so tough now, are ya?
I'm not exactly brimming with ideas, but Reddit? Well, Reddit's got some spicy suggestions on what shape the Herald of Galactus could take if he decided to cruise his way into the MCU. Let's talk Viggo Mortensen. You know him from his memorable role in Eastern Promises. Now, a bunch of actors from The Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit flicks have already joined the MCU, like Andy Serkis, Cate Blanchett, Benedict Cumberbatch, and Evangeline Lilly. But there's one big name missing, Viggo Mortensen, the legendary Aragorn himself. It seems Cap 1206 is vibing with the idea too, rooting for Mortensen to step into the Marvel Universe as Silver Surfer. And honestly, it's not a bad shout. Mortensen's got that chameleon-like ability to really embody his characters, which could make him a perfect fit for the role. Next in line is Rami Malek. You probably remember him from his Oscar-winning performance as Freddie Mercury in Bohemian Rhapsody. He also rocked the role of the big baddie in No Time to Die and stunned us all as Elliot Alderson in Mr. Robot. Now, AIDS for Life thinks Malek could be a stellar pick for Marvel's Cosmic Entity. Rami Malek would make a cool Silver Surfer, they say, and you know what? They might be onto something there. Malek's got this intriguing vibe that could really add depth to the ensemble cast. Moving on, we have Zachary Quinto. Known as Spock to a whole new generation of Star Trek fans, Quinto has proven his acting chops time and time again. From his breakout villainous role as Sylar in Heroes to his complex characters in American Horror Story, he's shown he can slip into any role seamlessly. Now, a Reddit user, KSA331, dropped a simple post, Zachary Quinto as Silver Surfer, alongside some photos, and it really caught fire among fans. They dove into recommendations of his past roles and discussed why he'd be a perfect fit for the character. It seems like it stirred up quite a buzz in the comment section. Coming up next is Alan Tudyk. You might remember him from the cult classic Firefly, where he shone bright. But what's really cool about Tudyk is his knack for changing his voice, which he's flaunted in Disney animated flicks and beyond. Plus, he's the comedic genius behind Resident Alien. Now, he might not be the biggest name on the list, but GrumpyBear911 sees some potential there. I'm going with an odd one and picking Alan Tudyk for the role, they say. And you know what? It's not as crazy as it sounds. Just like Riz Ahmed, Tudyk's got history with Disney and even dabbled in Star Wars as the droid K2SO in Rogue One. At last, we have the big shot, Keanu Reeves. You know who's been popping up a lot in the fan casting conversation? None other than Keanu Reeves. It's not hard to see why he's such a hot pick. I mean, he's nailed it as the dog-loving assassin John Wick and as the human savior Neo in the Matrix series. So, could he pull off the Silver Surfer too? One Reddit user, whose username seems to have vanished into thin air, threw out the idea of Keanu Reeves as Silver Surfer, paired with Liam Neeson as Galactus. Now, that duo might just be wishful thinking, but there's no denying that Reeves has won over the hearts of fans, making him a top choice for this iconic Marvel character. Let us talk about how the Silver Surfer can be a woman now, as I promised. So the new Fantastic Four movie is shaking things up a bit by bringing in a female version of Silver Surfer, played by Julia Garner from Ozark. This isn't the first time Marvel has tweaked a character's gender for the big screen, but it's definitely a notable change. In the comics, Silver Surfer is typically depicted as Norrin Radd, a dude from the planet Zenn-La who made a deal with the cosmic entity Galactus to save his world. But in this movie, it seems like they're switching things up by having a female character take on the Silver Surfer role. It's a fresh take on the character that's got fans buzzing with curiosity about what other surprises the MCU has in store. So in this new take on the Fantastic Four story, Julia Garner's character isn't playing Norrin Radd, but rather Shalabal. It seems like she's the one striking the deal with Galactus and becoming the Silver Surfer, doomed to roam the cosmos, searching for planets for her master to devour. Meanwhile, we're guessing Norrin might be left behind to lead Zenn-La in her absence. But here's where it gets interesting. There's a possibility that both characters end up becoming Silver Surfer. This idea isn't entirely new. There's a version of the Marvel Universe called Earth-X from 1999, where Norrin shares his power with Shala, and they both serve as heralds of Galactus. In this twisted future, Galactus isn't just some cosmic entity, but actually a super-evolved version of Franklin, the son of Mr. Fantastic and the Invisible Woman. Beside this, there's a theory floating around about the new Fantastic Four movie possibly being set in an alternate universe rather than the usual MCU we know and love. It's an intriguing idea that could explain why we haven't seen the FF in action until now. Maybe in this alternate universe, they just don't exist in the same way, or perhaps they got stuck in another dimension after their fateful space voyage. The inclusion of the Shala Baal version of Silver Surfer adds fuel to this speculation. It suggests that things might play out differently in this universe compared to what we're used to. Instead of Norrin Radd making that deal with Galactus, it's Shala Baal taking on the cosmic surfboard. But hey, that doesn't rule out the possibility of our beloved Norrin Radd surfacing in the MCU at some point. Another perspective to consider is that Marvel might have made this change simply to add more diversity to its cosmic hero lineup. If you take a look at Marvel's cosmic heroes, you'll notice it's mostly dudes dominating the scene, with characters like Nova, Beta Ray Bill, Darkhawk, Gladiator, and Adam Warlock taking the spotlight. Sure, we've got awesome ladies like Gamora, Mantis, and the recently introduced Phyla Vell from Guardians of the Galaxy, but they're outnumbered. So instead of diving into alternate universes and complex plot twists, Marvel might be aiming to balance things out a bit. Introducing a female version of Silver Surfer could be a step towards creating more gender diversity among their cosmic heroes. It's a move that not only freshens up the roster, but also reflects the diverse fan base and world we live in today. Marvel recently dropped a teaser image featuring Joseph Quinn's Human Torch against a backdrop of New York City, but it's not the NYC we're used to from the MCU. This skyline has a retro-futuristic vibe, hinting strongly that we're in for an alternate version of the Big Apple. And let's not forget the original Fantastic Four teaser art, which takes us back to a Life magazine cover from 1963. Putting these clues together paints a picture of a film set in an alternate Marvel universe, where it's 1963, and things have taken a different technological and fashion turn. It's like the FF themselves have left their mark on history, maybe with Pedro Pascal's Reed Richards playing a big part in shaping this new world, perhaps with his tech wizardry building a grander version of NYC. Well, that's it for today. What are your thoughts on the casting choices for the Silver Surfer? Do you think the Fantastic Four reboot will indeed be set in an alternate Marvel universe? Drop your comments down below and let's keep the conversation going. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you at the next one.